Hey everybody and welcome to this video. My name is Yannis, I'm a musician and producer, and in this video I want to show you how you can set up some external instrument in Ableton Live, which means that you can connect Ableton to any type of hardware instrument such as some analog synthesizer. And in this video, for this example, I'm going to connect Ableton Live to my Vermona Performer Mark II synthesizer. In the end, I'm also going to show you some small tricks on how you can even add some tiny processing and possibly interesting colors to your MIDI tracks before then sending them to a synth. So before even doing something inside the DAW, you need to make sure that your computer is actually connected to some MIDI input of your device, synth or drum machine, whatever you use. And there are actually two possibilities to do that. The first one is that your audio interface has some MIDI output, and so you connect the MIDI cable to this output and to the input of your hardware device. And you also have some USB MIDI adapter in case your interface, for example, doesn't have some output or you work without an interface or whatever. And so you have to plug in this USB thing to a USB slot, and then you have actually in and out at the other side of this adapter, and you have to plug the MIDI out of this interface into the MIDI in of your hardware device. And this way your computer is now connected via MIDI through the synthesizer, and you can open Ableton. So in Ableton we need to create a MIDI track, or maybe it's there already, and just open some external instrument by double clicking. And here under MIDI 2 you will now see your MIDI device, so either your USB interface or your real interface, and in my case it's the audio fuse because that's my audio interface and it has this MIDI out. And then here you can pick the channel. And maybe it doesn't make a huge difference because your device can only receive on one channel, but for example with the Vermona Performer it can receive four separate signals, so you can actually use channels 1 to 4. But here we just stick to channel 1 for now, and then we have to select where the audio comes from. In this case it's my input 3 and 4, and if I now press some note on the MIDI controller, we receive a signal. And if I would pick channel 2, you can see now I selected channel 2 for this second oscillator, and now this one receives the signal. And these are the very basics that you need to know in order to set it up for yourself. And here you also have some latency knob, although I recommend that if you have some latency issues, always check first the preferences. And if here your buffer size is very high, then it's usually the reason. So try to find the lowest possible buffer size. And then you also still need a solution for recording it, because now you can play it, but if you record something here, it's a MIDI track and it doesn't store any sound information. So we have to create some audio track and deselect inputs here. And then we send this external instrument to this newly created track, and you see that now we can actually arm it again. I have to keep this one armed as well. And now you see that it's sent to this channel, and now we could actually record some audio track. Now I messed something up in the beginning, but here you see we have some audio track now, and this way you can work with external instruments in Ableton Live. And one more thing, as I mentioned, that can be fun is to work with arpeggiators, and so you can put some arpeggiator that you find under MIDI effects in front of this instrument, so now it just plays your note rhythmically, as you can hear. You can pick different rates. The gate is just how open or tight the sound is. And now you have a thing called LFO under modulators, and you can map the LFO to everything. So for example, you could map it to the gate, and could get those kind of variations over time, which makes the sound more interesting, although I like the random waveform because this one gives you a lot of jumps that are unexpected and it's a little more, as it says, random, but this way it doesn't get static and it doesn't become the same type of repetition. It's just constantly something happening, which can be really pleasant. And which is also really interesting is to map it to the rate, but here you have to... And sometimes it's also nice to just find a smaller selection here. And actually a chord, it sounds terrible. And now this sounds really goofy, it's just an example, but for example, I like to use this a lot for my jazz standard videos, where I make arrangements of some jazz standards, and at some point I also always want to have some improvisation, so I actually have the chords as a MIDI channel, let the arpeggiator kind of make something out of those chords, and then have the LFO applied to the rate, because this way the rhythm changes, and because it also relates to some more steady rhythm and some harmony, it actually sounds more exciting than just by itself alone, because this way it just sounds really absurd. But mainly just want to encourage you to try mapping LFO or the LFO in Ableton to some MIDI effects, because this way you can actually add something to your sound even before you send it to your external instrument. And sometimes it can make the sound way more exciting than if you have your more static sequences. And you can do the same, of course, by assigning those knobs to a MIDI controller, so you can change the rate with a little fader, for example. And this is also something that can be really fun and sometimes add a lot of excitement. And also random can be nice because those styles are really symmetrical and either they go up or down or both. But if you pick random, it will be a little more absurd. And also the steps, this means you have more octaves. Oh, this actually starts sounding more interesting already. You get the idea, just play around with it. I can really, really encourage you to do so. And yeah, this is actually what I wanted to show you. And that's already it for today. I really hope you know now how to set up the external instrument so you can connect your favorite synth with Ableton Live, because I think it gives you great creative possibilities. If you happen to have the Performer, you can actually find a video here, or actually if you watch this in real time next week, where I speak about some composition concepts that apply specifically to that synth. And otherwise, I just wish you inspiration with whatever it is that you create, that you stay healthy, and I'd be super happy to meet you some other time again at my channel. Bye.